the main driver for this reverse engineering exercise is basically to find a way, a practical way, so that the students can apply what they learn in class on objects they know, and trying to see how things are made by themselves, exploring parts, and then connecting it to the course materials. And the main driver is the fact that this is a course that is very broad, involves a lot of different topics, many different processes, and it's always difficult to connect how these processes are applied. So I did prepare this course on the manufacturing technology with trying to find a way to avoid having a laundry list of processes we would be going through, but rather selecting a few of them and then highlighting them, and then now looking for a way on how they can use this content in specific cases and things they are observing every day. So we motivate the students by asking them to choose an object by themselves, something they like, basically, and something where they may have been curious to know how it was made. And then doing so, then they feel a bit, probably a bit more engaged into the course materials, and then they can try to connect what they learn with reality. And so it really gives it a bit more incentive for understanding the course topics and really what are the important aspects. Basically learning by doing.
En tant qu'ingénieur, donc c'est toujours intéressant de voir ce qui est fait dans le marché de nos jours et ce que des professionnels ont déjà fait, et d'apprendre un peu quelles techniques utiliser plus tard et à vraiment avoir une idée de ce que nous, plus tard, on pourrait faire.
Le choix du rasoir, on l'a fait principalement parce qu'on trouvait que c'était un objet très intéressant. C'était un matin en me rasant et on était en phase des recherches d'objets. Et je me suis dit, mais en fait, c'est parfait, quoi. Ça mélange tout ce qu'on aime en microtechnique.
Quand on a juste le rasoir, on a quelque chose un peu comme une black box, où quand on appuie juste sur le bouton, ça fait tourner le moteur. Et là, en le démontant, on peut voir quelles solutions ont été faites, comment on fait pour avoir plusieurs axes qui tournent en même temps à la même vitesse.
So the course is structured like any courses, with lectures on selections of topics and processes that are relevant to them, the most important one, because there's so many. And then in parallel, so every week, they can work on their little projects of this reverse engineering. And then as they go, as the course is going through the weeks, then they gradually learn more, and then they start to understand multiple aspects as they start disassembling their objects, starting to understand step by step how things were made, what is the price of it, how what can have been used, the materials, and so on. For most of the objects, we don't have the answer. We just don't know necessarily ourselves how it was made. So we go with them and look with them on how, you know, when they disassemble it, look at the parts with them and give them some methodology on how they can find out how it was made, make the right hypothesis.
Donc c'est un cours assez polyvalent où on voit toute la science des matériaux, les méthodes des usinages. Il y a même des côtés assez qui portent sur l'électronique. Donc on peut tout rassembler dans ce cours pour pouvoir étudier un objet de la vie réelle.
Dans ce stéthoscope, la pièce principale, c'est cette pièce-là, qui est le chest piece en anglais. On a commencé déjà par trouver un modèle physique à cette pièce-là. Puis on a fait une modélisation mathématique. Puis aussi on a fait une étude des matériaux, parce que les matériaux, ils comptent beaucoup dans ce cas-là, enfin, l'alliage, etc.
This is very interesting from that point of view because it's a bit like the scientific method, right? It's basically you formulate hypotheses and then you test them and try to validate or the opposite as you move along and progress into your understanding of the objects. It is a little bit of a game, yeah. Like you discover things as you disassemble, you see things you have not seen, so it's a bit like a hide and seek, sort of show and tell exercise. And so this gaming aspect of the project is also a nice addition to the class, I think.